Hello, friends. Happy Monday. Another great week. Kicking things off with this week's Monday mix-up on Nihon Yoru. Kicking things off with hole two, actually. A nice, straightforward, drivable par four. Give you an opportunity to get a double eagle hole in one, or at the minimum, hopefully a nice little putt in for eagle right there. GoldenTee.com/locations. Find a Golden Tee Live or Golden Tee PGA Tour game that has been updated to 2022 to get into today's contest. Hole two, typically hole nine, a par five. You've seen it in some of the previews over the last few months. You can get close to that green, but for the sake of not screwing up on the second hole, we're going to just hit a nice little driver with bite. Now, the reason I do bite is because backspin will give you more hops, and when you are trying to avoid the water down there, that is the last thing you want. So put bite on your shot to hopefully get it to settle down a little bit easier. Sometimes I've done it, especially on this hole, it is really easy to overthink even the sum of the simpler shots. So we move on here, number three, hole 12 in today's contest. You can go out to the right here. You gotta worry about that little tree up there if you're trying to do what I would consider the Kevin Lindsay shot, which is, let me just do a big old C3. With this wind, potentially you can get there. This is a tricky one. I'm just gonna go ahead and high tee this. Oh, I hit that too soft. So this is going to be a tough look for you there. But just like with every other daily contest we have, whether it's Monday Mix-Up or Freaky Friday, play as many times as you want throughout the day. So even if you make a mistake in the first game, play it out. Figure out the other holes. From experience, don't just quit. You make a mistake on hole three, play it out. You've paid for the game, play it out, learn the rest of the holes, and then play again and try to put all of those great shots together. Hole number four is hole 15, the drivable par four here. This one's not too bad. The pin's right in the middle, so you can do a nice little three wood. I wanted to get it a little bit farther to the left. Thought about using the 10.5 degree driver there, but I had a feeling that I would probably end up hitting that too far and getting wet on that hole. Moving on to hole number 10. Non-drivable par 5, par 4, at least for now. I am just going to put it up here in the rough. It doesn't really matter if you get in the rough. Just know that you're not going to get as much backspin out of it. I have super spin iron, so I will get a decent little kick here. And then we move on to putt for birdie there. Hole six, number three in the typical rotation. This is a fun little setup. I'm not even going to pull back. I'm just going to push that out there. Need it a little bit farther to the right, but that's all right. We're still putting in for birdie. As we move on to hole number seven, this is hole 13, another drivable par four. This is a tough one because do you either try to hit a five wood around these trees, which in this setup is very likely the shot we're going to go with. Do you go three wood, low three wood around here? That's also a possibility. If the wind was blowing to the right, I would say go that way. But for our sakes here, we're going to just hit a big old C3. Now, didn't get as close to the green as I'd hope, but you can tell from that shot there. That first cut is very sloped, so you have a chance, even when you hit it out too far, to at least get within chipping range to play it safe. Hole 8, number 7 typically at Nihon. This is a par 5. This is a tough one because you either stay short, and then you have a long shot to try to get to the green and stick the green with that kind of cliff face surrounding it here, or in the front part, or you're going to try what I'm going to try here, and you high tee a driver, and you want to get it out there as far as you can. This one shouldn't be too bad. You can at least get into the rough. And then at least here, you got to be careful because you're not going to get much backspin from a 5-wood out of the rough, but you'll at least have a putt in here for eagle. As we round out the front nine here, hole nine is actually hole 17. Now this one is tough because 8-wood's great, but you're up 10. That 11-mile-an-hour wind's not going to do much for you. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to play it safe, and I'm going to hit a 5-hybrid with bite. It did exactly what I was hoping for there. So, 14 after 9, not awful. That par 3, we should have been 15 after, but that's okay. And then hole number 10 is hole 1 here. Nice little 12-mile-an-hour wind. You're not going to necessarily be able to drive this hole, but I put roll on it for a reason, because I would like to take my 3-hybrid and at least give it a good go at it. Oh, the line was great. I just didn't hit it hard enough. That's okay. But when you play in a Monday Mixup or a Freaky Friday, sometimes you get these holes that, you know, end up on the back nine. And sometimes there's an opportunity to get an extra stroke you might not normally during a regular 18-hole game. Hole number 11, hole 6. You've seen it before. This is sometimes drivable. Not really the case with a lot of the setups lately. Not worth the risk here, so I'm just going to go ahead, hit a little 9-iron with super spin, take my birdie, and keep on rolling. Hole number 12 is hole 14 here. This is a fun little setup, 160 yards for the par 3. 6-iron with super spin. I'm going to probably either hit backspin and hit it hard. I may just move my tee and kind of cut in a 5-hybrid just to cut some of that distance off. You probably really don't need to do that, but it's like 3 cents for a tee, so if you've got those golden tees, you might as well use them. As we move on to hole 13. This is hole number 8, another par 3 from the front side of the course. I'm just going to do a little G-wedge release. Probably didn't need the release there. But so far, most of these par 3s have set up pretty decently to at least get in the GSP range. Not necessarily hole in one, but for the better players, maybe that is the case. Hole 14, drivable par 4. This is hole 9. I'm going to go ahead and actually just high tee this. Should have hit it out a little bit farther to the right, but again, going to have a decent putt here for eagle. Hole 15 is regularly number 16 on this course. This is that tricky par 5. Now, if you break it down and give yourself some time, it actually isn't as bad. Of course, you want to avoid these sand traps at all costs. You can lay up here in the kind of L shape of the fairway here. Some people actually hit it out to the fairway. What we're going to do, or try to do, is just hit a 10.5 degree driver. And I just hit it too short. Now, the problem is, I'm going to clear the trap. I just don't think I'll be able to get it there in one, but what the hell. Yeah, I didn't think that was going to work, but that's all right. It's a preview for a reason. All right, so par there was not really what we wanted to do, or excuse me, bogey, actually. As we get to hole 16, which is number 11, the other par 3, remaining par 3 from this course. Not as a aceable setup here. Also, I hit a high T5 hybrid. Not really sure how that didn't even get to the green, but hey. Again, this is why you play multiple games on the daily contest when it comes to Monday Mix-Up or Freaky Friday. Because you may make little mistakes, and you're going to know going into that second, third, fourth game how to be better because of it. As we get to the end here, hole 17, this is actually number 4, the drivable, or excuse me, the non-drivable par 5. But you've got a pretty heavy win that you don't normally get on this hole. So I'm just going to take a 6-wood. Use that 15 mile an hour wind to the advantage and see if we get it to drop. No, but it was close. 22 going into hole 18, which ironically is hole 18. And this may be the best setup I've ever seen on this hole. We're actually just going to ace this right now. So congrats to me on dropping this in. Oh, damn it. I knew it would be close. This is actually probably one of my favorite looks here on this hole. So 24 under, handful of mistakes throughout the game, but again, it is only game one of today's Monday mix-up. So goldentea.com/locations, find a PGA Tour or Golden Tee Live game that has been updated to 2022 near you. Stay tuned with us all week long, plenty of Golden Tee action. Also, Golden Tee Design a Hole. Contest ends tonight, goldentea.com/DAH. Make sure you get those submissions in for a chance to win a Golden Tee PGA Tour Home Edition. More on that to come this week.